Good morning to all, and we have completed our discussion about the different layers of the earth. Okay, and which are the three concentric layers of the earth?
Crust, mantle, and core.
Crust, mantle, and core. So the uppermost layer over the earth surface, it is
crust.
Okay, and it is classified into two. Which are they?
Continental
crust and oceanic crust. And what about the thickness? Is it the same for both these crusts?
No, ma'am. Continental crust is 5 kilometers.
35 kilometers.
Okay, and what about the oceanic crust?
5 kilometers.
Okay, so children, so we have seen that it is solid in state. Okay, so it is solid in state, and we know that the place where we live in, okay, the earth crust, it is made up of rocks and minerals, and it is covered by a thin layer of soil. Okay, and it is thickness is different for the continental crust and for the
oceanic crust.
And what about the mineral constituents, Aaron Jomi? The mineral constituents of continental crust.
They are in liquid state. Not
audible. You're muted. Yes.
Question.
Can you hear Aaron?
Yes.
No, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
See, and tell me. Yes. The main mineral constituents of the continental mass.
Ma'am, Cl.
Yes. Silica and
aluminum.
Alumina. Okay, don't be confused with that. Okay, so silica and alumina, it is thus called Zial. Okay, then what about the mineral constituents of oceanic crust?
Silica and magnesium.
Okay, silica and magnesium.
Cima.
Okay, and just beneath the crust, it is mantle. Which extended up to a depth of 2,900 kilometers. Okay, and we have discussed that it is liquid in state, okay, molten in state, okay. And as we and what about the temperature of the this layer, you know, children, crust,
that is 400 degrees Celsius to the boundary.
Okay, when we reaches to the boundary of mantle, it is 400 degrees Celsius. Okay, so starting from 24 degrees Celsius to 400 degrees Celsius. As we go more deeper into the earth, the temperature, it's become high.
3,700 degrees Celsius.
So this one is mantle. It's just beneath the crust. It is mantle which extended up to a depth of 2,900 kilometer. Okay, just below the crust. Okay, and it is molten in state. Right, children?
Yes, ma'am.
Good. Okay, the rocks and the minerals of this layer, it is in a molten state. It is in a liquid state because of high temperature. It is in liquid. Okay, it is in liquid form. And what about the temperature?
400 degrees Celsius to 3,700 degrees Celsius.
Even we can't imagine, isn't it, children? That means it is too hot. Okay, the temperature is high in this layer. Okay, and I have told you about the mineral constituents of this layer.
Yes, ma'am. Iron and magnesium.
So this this is all about mantle. Okay, just beneath the crust, it is mantle, and it is the rocks and minerals. this layer. It is in a molten state. Okay, the lava, that means the molten magma, due to extreme heat, sometimes it comes out. Okay, it comes out, and the temperature, it is very high. That means 400 degrees Celsius to 3700 degrees Celsius. And the mineral constituents of this layer, the main mineral constituents, that is iron and magnesium. Now, I have told you about the deepest mine in the world. Okay, it is in South Africa, and it's about 4 kilometers deep. And it dug a hole about 6 kilometers deep inside to the earth. And I have told you about another important hole made by man. Okay, it is in Russia, it is a man-made, it's not a yes.
Can you hear?
Yes. Okay. Children, we cannot go into the center of the earth. Okay. And why it is a too difficult task or an impossible task to reach inside to the earth?
Because of the high temperature.
Because of the high temperature. Okay, as you go more deep into the center, the temperature is becoming high. Okay, so we human, it's not possible to sustain such a huge.
Then there will be no oxygen also.
No, we need oxygen to go inside. Okay. Yes. And the next. You know, children, about the core.
Ma'am, can you show the previous slide?
Wait. Okay. Children, so we have discussed about the core. That means the innermost layer over the earth surface. Okay. Which is the innermost layer?
Core.
Okay. Core. And you know, children, even there is the temperature, it is high. Okay. And also, you know, it is high pressure. Okay, this layer, it is experiencing high temperature and also high pressure. So the rocks and minerals of this layer, it is in a semi-molten state. What do you mean by semi-molten state?
Half solid, half liquid.
Okay, so why, you know, mantle, it is high temperature is very high. So that rocks and minerals, it is in a liquid state. Okay, but here in this layer, you know, children, the temperature is high and also high pressure. Okay, so this layer experiences high temperature. The temperature is very high there. At the same time, high pressure. Okay, because of this extreme pressure and temperature, the rocks and minerals of this layer, it is in a semi-molten state. Okay, so that it is a whitish, reddish color. Okay, it is somewhat whitish, reddish color. Okay, whitish red color. So semi-molten state. And can you imagine the temperature of this layer, children?
No, ma'am.
11,000 degree.
Okay. It was a wild guess, isn't it? Forgot your name. Vivian, right? Yes. You know, children, it's about 7,200 degrees Celsius. When we reach to the inner core or inner boundary, it reaches to 7,200 degrees Celsius. And you know, children, the innermost layer core, it is the innermost layer over the earth. Okay, innermost layer of the among these three concentric layers, and its radius is about 3,500 kilometers. What do you mean by radius? Volume and radius? Have you studied it in maths?
No, ma'am.
No, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
What is radius means? Radii.
Ma'am, the distance between the center of the circle and the end of the circle.
To a point. Okay. Volume means? The total space equal to keep an object. Okay. Understand?
Yes, ma'am.
From the center to a point. Okay. So it's radius, you know. It's about 3,500 kilometers. And the main mineral constituents, it is nickel and iron. Yes. Nickel and iron. And you know the scientific name of iron, it is ferrous. Okay, so it is Ni-Fe. For iron, we will use ferrous. So it is Ni-Fe. And we know that the central core has very high temperature under pressure. Okay, the temperature, very high temperature under pressure. Okay, so children, these are the three concentric layers of the earth. Crust, mantle, and core. The crust is the uppermost layer over the earth's surface, the place where we live in. Okay, and the temperature is comparatively low. And when we move, as we move deep inside to the earth, you know, the temperature, it's becoming high. Okay, and mantle, just below the crust, it is mantle. And we know that it is the thickest layer. Okay, it is the thickest layer, you know, children. And the temperature, it is very high, and also the liquid state. Okay, molten magmas can be seen in this layer, and the core, the innermost layer over the earth surface, and innermost layer, and it is high temperature and pressure. Okay, this layer, it experiences very high temperature and pressure. Its radius is about 3,500 kilometer, and the mineral constituents of this layer, okay, core, it is nickel and iron. Yes. Together it is Ni-Fe.
Ni-Fe.
Okay, Ni-Fe. Okay. So these all about the different layers of the earth. Do you have any doubt in any points which we have discussed today?
No, ma'am.
No, ma'am.
We will move on to we will just compare it with the layers of the earth. That we will compare it with a boiled egg. Okay, you know, children, the outer shell, you know, when we we used to boil the egg, isn't it, children?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, and when we cut, you know, the outer shell, the white part of the, the outer shell of the egg. Okay, we can compare it with the
crust.
Okay, very thin layer. It forms the outer shell of the egg. Okay, the same way the earth crust. Okay, it is the outer shell. And the whitish part, you know, children, we can compare it with the
mantle.
Okay, the egg white. Okay, the egg white, we can compare it with the mantle. And the yellow yolk.
And we can compare it with
core. Okay. We can compare it with the
core.
Okay, so we are just comparing it with a real life, means real life, means thing. Okay, that means the white outer shell of the boiled egg, we can compare it with the crust, and the egg white, we can compare it with the mantle, and the yellow yolk, we can compare it with the core. Okay, then children, do you have the textbook with you?
Yes, ma'am.
Page number 8.
No, ma'am, I don't have my textbook with me.
Okay, you just note down the points. Page number 8. Do you know, one column, the crust forms only 1% of the total volume of the earth. Underline that sentence.
Ma'am, which page?
Page number 8. Do you know one column is given on the left side?
Can you read that line once more?
The crust forms only 1% of the total volume of the earth. And 84% consists of mantle.
15%.
And 50% makes the core. So crust forms only 1%. Okay, so the crust forms only 1% of the volume of the earth, and 84% consists of the mantle, and 15% makes the core. And underline the next sentence too. The radius of the earth is 6,371 kilometers. The total volume means which is the thinnest layer?
Crust.
Okay. And which is the thickest layer?
Mantle.
Okay, so the thinnest and the thickest layer. Thinnest it is crust, and thickest layer it is mantle. So 84%. Okay, so 84% consists of mantle. And only 1% forms the crust. And so total radius, it is about 6,371 kilometer. These all points are important, children. It will come for MCQ test. Now I'll try to